is on color, basically color image processing and the application. Obviously, and you will find most of the applications for color image processing would be in the area of natural products, white agro products. Of course, color applications are everywhere. Color image processing is generally taken as next step after going through preliminary orientation course in image processing. So, accordingly, I chose one area where special color image processing is used. And I didn't know Professor Vinod had to come on giving a talk for medical image processing. So the high level or high depth of medical imaging that you must have seen comes in the medical imaging. And the usual imaging, applications, I would say the 8-bit kind of applications, the standard applications where speed is more important, is generally in the industrial application and in sometimes security, strategic and other sectors. So unfortunately, I have not taken the initial set of applications that generally I give to the audience, assuming that some production is already over by now. So I have taken just a step ahead of what the audience would have gathered by now. I think it's now 10 days, you know,
7 days
are over. So this application, set of applications is towards color, which is richer than the imaging that you start with. So I hope I don't think I would make things more complex as one might guess, but the idea is to give you a broader feeling of how image processing goes everywhere or many ways. So you can imagine. The nature gives us all the colors. In fact, if you see the richness of a fresh tomato, as you can see in this picture, and many other, and the products, I'm using the word products, and that's what the agro industries call their raw fruits and vegetables as products. And now you find even in markets wherein you find an apple with an inspected word written on that. The labels of thought, those kinds are now available. So you find that each product, if I use the word agro product, also gets inspected as good as any product, say mobile or anything that you own from the industry. So agro industry, agro products are also, as they are called, coming from agro industries. So sometimes they do all then further into food processing and other things. So so basically the idea of giving you all that introduction in the beginning was to give you a feeling of richness, the richness that the color information has it, and we all human beings enjoy and make use of the decisions that we make by comprehending color. And some of you, if you have come across, do have variations in color, and that, as we know, in some medical fields also called color blindness and all. So there are color variations also in which we all perceive colors, and so is the case with machines also. But anyway, those are further exceptions to the color image processing. At the moment, I thought I would give you a broad, I'll just go next, as this, the summary of presentation. Wherein I give some introduction as I have just started with some examples and approaches, wherein it gives you a feeling of how color is usable and color image processing is usable in sorting, grading or inspecting the real natural products, as we call them now. And then I take one serious application, detailed application that most of you had the chance to see at a glance, that is rice grading and application and classification, because that time we had a present a demonstration and I thought I could be appropriate justice to treat it in this session. So that will go in detail, and then we finally have conclusion, the overall feeling of the house as to how the whole area of color image processing is really, really has enriched you. So that we can really have views and opinions, wherein we can have clarifications also of what we know today and what we had in the lab when you visited. Unfortunately, I am not putting any of the applications other than this at the moment that you had a chance to see. If you feel you have any questions on those, I would rather welcome and include. And if you are not able to do it today, you will keep including them for the next session, if we can have it on Friday, wherein you can have all sorts of questions. And I personally like audience response in the form of questions, while I say, Aristotle said, no question is wrong, only the answers are wrong. So therefore, please bear in mind, all questions are correct. My answers can be wrong or right, so you take the privilege of putting all the questions at the moment, or of course, we can see appropriately at what time, but I would see that by the end of the same session, and when you have it on Friday, or today, for whatever is covered. So, okay, I go ahead and hold on here for a moment. I just want to ask, in fact, all of you, most of the, I find the larger audience in females here, how do you really buy tomatoes? Who is the best buyer of vegetables or fruits? In a family, normally the lady of the house. But anybody, can you say, if you were to say by apples or any vegetable, all vegetables are different colors. You know, if you have, so anybody wants to give a tip on that? That would help us in forming an algorithm probably. No, because that's the domain knowledge anyway. A person who is working on this area as a research and never ever bought vegetables or fruits or anything, should not work, I would say. So if he doesn't go to the vegetable or fruit or anything buying, or he doesn't have liking for the natural colors and natural products, then hardly I would say he would come up with a good algorithm. Probably then somebody else would help him and then he would put his algorithm. But originating of the algorithm would come from what I am trying to say, as to how do you really buy. If you were to buy an apple, what do you do for that?
What do you mean?
Yeah, it should be rich in color, shape and size, and should not have any surface defects. So when you approach a particular vendor, you find there are, for future average color is grand. And then you go to the particular piece by piece selection as to what would be the best for me, isn't it? So color, shape, size is generally a kind of a tool as a primary set of features, the three set of things that you find. And of course, when you say color, shape and size, the visibility of all that comes on the surface.
Hardness also.
The most important that is missing, when I said, when you go there, you start holding it. So there's no vision then. The firmness, as they call it. Firmness is something, and many times you find a vendor may say, please don't touch my apples, isn't it? Don't press them to test the firmness. That is what we get called non-destructive or destructive testing. If everyone starts testing the firmness, by the end of the day, a particular apple or a tomato might have become rotten. 100 people have pressed it. So that is the firmness test, and firmness test is the physical pressure testing that is also separate to vision. So image processing is something, you know, looking through a glass, doesn't have a touch or a firmness kind of test. That goes the next step actually for many of the products. So this one as such is only visible, you can see. It's only appearance. And you can imagine appearance is also deceptive. So this is not a foolproof or a kind of sure confirmed test for all the products. In some cases, yes, in some cases it may not be. So it may not be considered as the proto kind of agro products inspection, but there will be other tests required for each, or if it is each product or if it is even if it is a lot of, say, grains, as we gave example for rice or anything else. I think there is some missing. Anyway, there is some CMERI. These are the three labs which were involved in the in this project. Unfortunately, I am not going to give details of this, but you will have a look of what we just discussed as to how the how a particular product of this kind, say apple or tomato or oranges or any other fruit, would require inspection. So, what you miss is when you see the whole of the apple. Do you see the whole of tomato? Can you see the whole at once? Or how do you see? Do you keep rotating it? Do you keep viewing it all the way? Or do you miss something, you know, particularly when you buy brinjal, you must have missed some holes in it. Many of you miss the holes, say, oh, when I come back, there is some problem in that. Because the color is missing and the darkness with which that brinjal has a color. So many of you, even if it's so big, you find a mistake in that. Maybe tomatoes and apples are easier to buy. So it is not an easy task, I'm just trying to say that. There would be chances of missing some problems. The defects are not easy to detect, isn't it? So this is a project which was there, you know, involving three laboratories. Somehow I think the display is missing. Can you change some resolution? Or? No, there is a right part. CMERI is also written on the side. The display you have chosen, I think there is some problem. So we are missing part of the image on the right side. Okay, the CMERI is a laboratory which is also involved. In fact, the machine is lying at Durgapur. So can you play this? Just click on the image. Yeah, please have a look. Are moving on the conveyor belt and also weighed. Each piece is weighed. That is what I wanted you to see. So there are rollers on which each apple is spinning. At a rate. And then they get sorted out. So the idea is to see the apple. The machine cannot have a big judgment or doesn't have two eyes. So the whole system, this idea of giving you this video was to show you that even to see a cylindrical object, you may have to rotate it like that. And each rotation, all rotations put together only can make a surface. It's like opening a globe basically. So in this case, if it is apple, It is the axial spinning has given you, and many of you might have observed, even this is not 100% surface. Even if you see all the surface from a camera, which is not visible here, the other video I think they are not able to play. But it doesn't matter. The idea is during this motion they go to an imaging chamber, wherein multiple images are grabbed, and then basically the idea is to get a whole surface. So it's like unrolling the surface of it. Say if this is the cylindrical object, you unroll the whole cylinder as a two-dimensional, say rectangle. Many of you can say the stem part of the apple is not well inspected here, and it's the other side also. Basically, the critical parts are not well inspected, but the color, the overall redness, green or yellowness and all that, majority of the color gets inspected. So the idea of giving this was to give a dynamic motion as a necessity for such products inspection if you want the whole of it or even major part of it to be inspected. Particularly when the objects are, you can imagine no fruit is so simple to inspect by way of say such kind of machine vision systems. And also I would give you, because if I discuss this more, it will become more of, you will find all mechanical engineering, precise mechatronics, precise motion, and then triggering lot of electronic hardware and mechanical, and the imaging aspects are far behind the scene. So that's why some of the application that I thought I would discuss are later given a glance of applications, and then the application on rice. where you can have a feel of color on the static image processing. So these are all machine vision based, with wherein you require motion, and lot of other engineering is required before you actually get into the color or any image processing. So there is a lot of other multidisciplinary requirement, and these are machines basically. They are not just algorithms. There are a lot of machinery requirement, and that finally gives the application. Next. So if you see now, giving you now another cross section, now you can imagine apples are relatively still well disciplined in shape and size. Now potatoes, they hardly have any shape. I mean, you don't know, the shape is so, and to allow potatoes to be inspected is even difficult. And the easiest probably would be eggs, relatively. The easiest in the sense, the reliability of the shape is high on in case of eggs. And onions, of course, could have similar, slightly better than potatoes, but still have shape, color, and size problems. And there, somewhere here, it shows also ham for fat, white fat, and the length, width, the how much overall area you can generate when you cut non-vegetarian material. So the idea is all these are color, shape and size issues, and many of them, like for this you would require, okay, how much of white is there? That would mean, you know, further color image processing to divide area into various things. So what is common in all of them is the, as she said earlier, color, shape and size, and I put brackets, in some cases the shape and size are also ignored. So only color is, you will find the whole potato has been inspected only for say color defects and never bothered about shape and size, because probably we had no way to do that, or we had some way to do in case of say in case of this, they say you have to go for shape and size. So sometimes we are not able to do all those. This is just to give you a cross section of various kind of, this is not various, in fact, this small 3 or 4 number. So let us see if I take one of them next to give you. Well, this is of course on simpler situation, you can imagine why all that is required. It shows why all that is required. That I don't know, in India, of course, we don't find, I don't know whether you see there are the machinery for such inspection of eggs and all, but as such, we have seen. If you go abroad, you will find there are, you know, large eggs, small eggs, and medium eggs, and all. There are eggs are also sorted as size. So before that size is all that is done, there are defects on the surface. You can imagine they are not as clean as you saw in the image that we saw. There are a lot of dirt, egg yolk, blood, and feces. I mean, all kind of dirt that you can imagine in that environment would be there on the surface. So while the whole thing goes on, there has to be some inspection, and the production is, you can see the target here, around 1 lakh eggs per hour. Probably the large poultry must be doing with that. This is just an application I could gather from literature, because I found it is relatively simpler in comparison, because the color wise there are, as you will see, the color variations are not there. Primarily, it is the surface inspection of the defects that is primary in this case. So, as you will see, the high resolution cameras, and what you miss in, what we have not yet discussed is the illumination, which you can't avoid. Though I try to suppress the motion and mechatronics and other machine vision aspects of the imaging, but one cannot ignore, now once you want to see the whole thing, means in rotation, the uniformity of illumination is a prime requirement. So if you see something in color, you remember, you know how you shop. When you go shop, you want to have particular lighting. You know, they demand, the business shops also, they maintain lighting so that you have an appropriate judgment of the colors. So therefore, here also as it is not just the resolution or the quality of imaging that will matter, it is primarily the illumination that gives the quality. The imaging quality also depends on how uniform the color, how the illumination was done. So these are some of the issues I thought I would bring next. If you see now, here is the situation you can imagine, typical, not as clean as you saw in the first picture, is actually a typical case of all damage to kind of, you know, these are, you know, most of them are shown as defective. Next, if you see another, this is of course wrong. No, another, this is all egg yolk spilling over the surface. So I don't know what they treat. Most of the time, these are sorted separately. The bad ones are separately. They are sorted as you saw the apple sorted out separately by a pusher. They are generally bins of. It's basically a classification machine, which takes everything and sorts them into two or three categories. These are all the machines do. They take the products as lot and they just divide them into not more than two or three or four, I would say, maximum categories, as to say class 1, class 2, class 3, or in this case say yolk, surface error or a dirt or anything, and then good ones, clean ones. So that is the idea of just giving the problem as such. Now how it is done basically? As I said, in the case of apple, there was a rotation. Potatoes, etc., they can't rotate. No, you can't spin that. So many times they roll. Sometimes they roll on special rollers you saw for apples. Or they have long rods wherein the rods keep rotating and the conveyor belt mechanism gives them motion. I don't want to give you, I don't think you would be expecting that kind of details. So I just showed that video only to give you motion. But to give you a feeling of, in this case, each object, say apple or egg of, in this case, would require multiple images. If I show you the imaging next, you see now next, it would require an imaging. First thing is that you have to have a large production. Means you can't have each egg. Even if it is each egg or apple, it has to be in high speed or it has to be in multiple rows. So there the production is the target. Their idea is to have as much as possible. So particular set of imaging mechanism is done, putting a camera at one place, putting a camera at the other, the things move from the other direction. So in this case, the motion goes here, see the arrow here, and camera 1 is on this side, the camera 2 is on the other side, and each row is visible to each camera from one side or the other. So what this camera can see, this cannot see that same surface. So if you see that next, you see the next one, for one particular egg you would require this kind of imaging, half the imaging visible on one, half the imaging visible on the other, and the defect is so spread that it is visible in different images. That's what happens in that apple detail also. You have one camera, while the apple is rotating or while the egg is moving in this case, you find that a surface defect. This is the same defect which is spread over multiple images. So the idea is that although a small defect of this much may be permissible, but when they understand that the direct defect is leading, the defect is joining with the next images. So put together, it's like cycle of, even this is included in that. So the whole cycle of rotation, they know they index actually that this is the egg surface 1, 2, 3, 4, and then put together, there are 8 images up and 8 images down, and that whole imaging would require the processing wise. You can see processing wise, it's basically the area intensity variation detection. So it's histogram or any other suitable method. As you can see, there's a change in color here from the uniform brown to a dark brown kind of patch. So they don't know the details. Unless they know that whether they want to have egg yolk, if it is yellow color, or it is a particular dark, dirty surface patch on the product. So if there is a further classification required, then they do for that. So at the moment, it is only showing that there is a defect on the surface. Next, there is another. This whole approach I have just given you basically that there are two cameras and. This detail, 2 into 8 images per egg are required during motion. So there is a rate of imaging required, that as the eggs are moving, you have one image and another motion, another image. As you can see, the image, since the egg is just moving, you can see this, and the images from each surface are available. Next. this also shows a slightly different approach in this case. You see the, can you see the rollers here? In this case, there are rollers behind, similar to the apple. Here, the less, since they are rotating also, next, you see the number of images are, in this case, 2 × 45 degrees, basically 4 different views during rotating. There, the numbers of images are less because thus they are also rotating. So, it's a really a difficult task of how to orient. It's like, you know, Earth is rotating, so you can have the images available from satellite, and you have the whole Google Earth and everything. But here the objects are not rotating. You have to make an arrangement that it's like a fashion parade, basically. It's like you have to move, it's like one has to move on the ramp and move around and show everything, and then the object gets inspected. This is also no less than that. And you can imagine a lot of engineering behind. At the moment, in fact, I am not giving you too much details of color image processing. I will come to the fundamentals of that now, after just giving you a glimpse of the examples, to give you a feeling that there are a lot of other issues involved in making an application. So it's just a spectrum of related issues, you can see. Next. So now you can see, there is of course domain knowledge now. All that knowledge has to come from experts of the agro, you know, field. They will tell us, we don't know. For example, it's like asking somebody, what are the skin defects of human beings? I mean, the skin specialist will tell you, this is one eczema and all that. You know, hundreds of defects may be there. We don't know whether skin cancer or spot or eczema. Similar to that, we have, these are the some domain names, and some are simpler names given in English. So it's like growth crack. This is again not a purpose of giving you the details of them, but just to give that there are, in this case, six kind of classes of defects. For us, as a you can say engineering application, we see how many classes. As I said, we have to make a classification of the defects. So these are cracks. Then these are again scabs, and greening of apple is also a lot of concern. These potatoes is a serious kind of thing, as I read somewhere. And, but although we find that many times you find by potatoes and they are greening. Particularly, there are chips industries. There is a, in fact, CPRI, you know, Central Potato Research Institute. They are having a project with us for storage of potatoes. Of course, not for this, but they were also looking for color so that the chips manufacturing industry can decide as to what level of exit from the food storage should be used so to have proper chips formation. So that is not the defects part of it, but the color part. Next. Okay, so this gives again, the idea of giving this was to give you only how the color imaging would require. Look at this. If you had a chance to see color 3CCD color camera in the lab, we had. Many of you had that medical application was, you know, being developed using 3CCD cameras. So what I'm trying to say. So now I'm coming to the at least the electronics part of the whole system, wherein you require 3 digital CCDs for color image processing. And in this case, 3 CCDs means a usual camera that you all enjoy is not a true color camera. None of you have a color camera with you, no matter what sophistication it is. The 3 CCD camera means there are three basically cameras in one. And there are 3 separate filters for each. So for potatoes and all color inspection, the camera that you must have seen was a big camera, which requires image split into 3 colors, basically. And there are 3 separate colors. Normally, the cameras that we all get photographed are not, they are only single CCD. And they are there is a clever way of finding color with them. In this case, the true color means the separate 8 bits per CCD pixel are available from 3 CCD. So each has the filter, say red, green, blue, or the camera that you saw, in fact, was not red, green, blue. It was color infrared, So there was no blue in that camera that you saw in our lab. That was meant for Apple's inspection, because you find the blue color somehow is rarely used. I don't know if anybody can tell me any blue color in well, Brinjal maybe, the kind of shade that we have. But in general, the products that you find, the blue color is generally absent. So it's color green and yellow and, you know, those set of bands. And infrared is an additional band that gives you penetration of defects inside the skin. So infrared imaging goes beyond the skin. So it's they say the skin deep. It's like whether you know the facts, skin deep or more. The infrared goes beyond skin deep. So that's why we use that sort, so that defects, the apples have a problem. There are some defects which are not visible at all, but there are defects within the skin. So the infrared is used there. So similarly here the just to give you a brief idea, potatoes are made to have imaging in mirrors. You know, they have like multiple mirrors in a room. You can imagine all sides of the product are visible, and of course they are in motion. So what they do is they want all of them to move in a larger area, as you will see next. And see this, the potatoes come in a basically roller station, where the speed is differentiated V1, V2, V3. The last speed has 1.5 meters per second. It is a commercial system. We had also seen another literature wherein basically mirrors are necessary. What I'm trying to say here, without mirrors you will not be able to see the potato, because it's so odd in shape that you cannot have anything else. But potatoes, by and large, they want all of them to move in a manner that in a crowd movement, all get moved to a situation that they expose themselves. That is the idea. They expose themselves to an imaging area where the whole surfaces are surface defects get accumulated in different snapshots. So it may be difficult for you to get the whole idea of mechanisms. And the idea is that finally they got into bins. So now next. And this goes in all real, basically, in real speed at all. Now I am trying to give you, maybe you had some glimpse of the possible applications. And in between, as I mentioned, I had planned to give you now some good treatment on the color imaging, how deeply as a kind of algorithm developer, if you call yourself, and the course that you are attending, where you get details of after the acquisition, what goes as the system development. So now I'm giving you some academics on color image processing, and then you take up the application that you have already seen to have a justice of what you know and what you saw as demonstration. So with the broader aspects of color image processing and its application, now I'm trying to give you the in-depth wherein you can have your queries in detail, so that you can see how a total application gets developed. So this treatment is starting with a representation. It will go into how the color image processing is dealt, particularly the color image models that we use, and then the application, how we have dealt with the application on rice classification and grading. So at this moment, I would see that you rather help me to elaborate on what you have already gathered. Did you have any part of this color models or anything in the course today?
I can't reproduce.
Okay, so
it's daily class
or not? Today?
No, not today.
Okay. So this is also in a way similar to what you will see later on, but I have also put together something that I thought would be necessary for them to know considering an application on color image processing. So basically, somebody could say that if it is monochrome image that we have understood, it could be three. When I said 3 CCD, we also call it RGB or similar to that RGB. I said CIR also. Whatever be the colors given to the CCDs, each imaging sensor has its own color. It's basically you wear red goggles on one eye and say green goggle on the other eye. What do you see? Probably you would say, I need another eye to have blue also. So that would be the true color appreciation.
That's eventually they have CD matter.
They have seen in split of that RGB. So the RGB, no, that split you know that. So that is the starting point here. That is what we assume, that any 24-bit image acquired from a camera or any line scan camera or any methods that we are somehow now suppressing, those details we are not bringing here, is a color RGB true color image. So that is the starting point. Now that means each pixel has three dimensions, three parameters to carry. And they are typically, not always, typically red, green, blue shades of the particular point pixel. So that much you know, I believe, and it's just split of the color to three. So, but as I mentioned, sometimes it need not be RGB, it could be something else. So the idea is that whether this RGB model suits us or not, that we will see later on. So basically now it's a three types. Whole memory requirement, processing requirements, at the moment appear to be all three types. Just go next. So this is you know, probably splitting of image into three, that each pixel now has row wise, if you see, there are, if you say row 00, zero, row 01 means it's a zero row and zeroth first column, first pixels, zero pixels are second. So it's a, if it is n by, n only, it's a kind of square image. So you have basically three images. That much I believe you all can. This is just so that shows that there are three matrices now. Split, the original image has been split into separate. So this is R, this is green, this is blue. Typically from say, M into N kind of image if you say. So this is the way the representation goes inside any algorithm development. That is the starting point. Next. So now this is sometimes not all, as I said, if particular lighting, if the lighting in this case, for example, is yellow, suppose the bulb, the illumination is not proper, you would find that colors get very easily distorted. A particular object may, the red apple may appear different. Particularly there are vegetable vendors, you put yellow light on the shop, you get whole confused, isn't it? The idea is that there has to be an appropriate color representation, and that means if the color is white, it must be white in RGB also, which is not the case in many situations. Particularly if I just say, if I show you next, you will find that the camera, just go next, first I will show you the next. Okay, now if this one shows actually how the left and right images are not exactly same, though physically, geometrically you can see they are same, but the color wise they are not same. That is a situation where the color adjustment is not appropriate, where the all the three shades are not well balanced, what we call color balancing. A particular monitor may have, it's like red tinge, you know many monitors or many displays, many cameras like Fuji color, you know, particularly they have another kind of tinge. So the idea is that many times the imaging is not appropriate. So color imaging, that way one has to be clear that there is a lot of error possibility if this is not well balanced in the beginning itself. So there is a lot of color automatic adjustments are done in many monitors, cameras and all. There are ways of balancing the color. Basically the gain in say green or blue and red are not equal. So that makes a problem. Like if the whole white is given, red is showing some value and green is showing some other value. It's like a bright student is scoring 100 out of 100 in math, then 60 marks in physics, 70 marks in chemistry, and there is some problem. I mean, there is no balancing of the things. It's like RGB is like PCM, physics, chemistry, math. I'm just trying to make an analogy. So if that happens, that means there is no balancing. One has a twist or kind of in particular interest or a strong angle or bias in particular direction. So these kind of situations give you, you know, unbalanced color and it requires balancing. Next. This also shows that particularly the white balancing is the best way to do that. That if this color should be white, if it is known to be white, it must, the imaging system also should generate white. That means all RGB should be equal. White means the red, green and blue should be equal for white colors. And for black colors, all should be zero. So if this is not happening, that means there is a problem. And you can imagine it's a three times more problem. The color balancing or color matching is such a difficult task, particularly on this issue that illumination is not correct, your imaging system is not correct. Of course, despite all that, we have to develop certain algorithms. But if it is to have actual color matching, then you have a problem. If you want to say red tomatoes, you will have a problem that you may not find red tomatoes coming red and red. If it involves all the colors. So if you can manage with say single color, then of course it's different. So that is the idea of giving you color deviation that can occur. So your calibration must require that black should have all zeros and all white should have all ones or a full value of the 8 bit say. If it is 255, so it should have all 255. Next. So now I'm trying to give you the model that is required that would be useful in the application that we have planned next after this. So if some of you must have heard of this model, hue, saturation and intensity kind of. And why we need all that? Why do we need this? Why do we have to have another model? Did you ever come across that your printers do not use RGB? Yeah, it's an accurate
hue
is it's a better representation of the color as far as the processing is image processing. Yeah, except for your first sentence which you said, others are great. First thing you say easier. I don't think that the easier might be RGB straight away. But the other points are important that they are true to the way the humans see their objects. They are true, they are also true towards how they are perceived by us as well as the models, the imaging sensors. And also the illumination changes. As I said, you have a red tomato. You have it here, move from here to that light source. Go on imaging it. You will find all the shades are different. The same tomato or apple or any object will keep varying in all. The lighting variations are so drastic when you choose RGB. Because RGB is it's like XYZ coordinate system and R theta, cylindrical coordinate system or other system. Exactly you can imagine. This is in line with that. The RGB model is quite like XYZ. No robot, most of the robotic systems do not prefer the Cartesian system. Because they work with motors. It's easy to play with motors angles rather than XYZ. When you say move from one XYZ to another XYZ by just even one step, you require all the three motors will move. All the three coordinates will change. All the three coordinates from the control side will change. Here also it happens the same way. If you change even a little of light, all RGB will change and you will not have a feeling what is this happened. That means it is vulnerable to illumination. Basically the RGB is vulnerable to illumination. That's why if you sit with the two monitors, I am telling you sit with two monitors for 1 hour, 2 hours or 5 hours. You cannot match them. Though they can be matched, it's not impossible to match. But you go on playing with one image, try to have matching, keep increasing something, keep increasing the gain of R, G, B, anything you keep playing, you will not fail. It's like color matching is then almost impossible. Matching part, if you want to match one with the other. So that's the reason. Basically, the practical reasons are there. So we have a transform. You can say like a transform or a change of model. From RGB. So RGB is good for electronics device manufacture. Photodiodes and photo, whether they are detectors or whether they are display devices, they will use RGB. Even RGB is not used by printers. You see what are the colors used in printer. What are the colors you have seen? They use color cyan, yellow, and magenta. CY, that's magenta, CYM. Similarly, there are CYMO and many models are used here. Because in a printer, if you want to print black color, you can't say absence of all the colors. You have to print black separately and white separately. And display-wise, things are different. So let me just show next how. So it is this. I may not take more of time here to elaborate this because this is, I would say, a personal exercise to give you how the whole thing gets developed here. But the easiest would be to discuss the models and how the formula conversion goes in. Just for a brief discussion, I have put it here so that you know the color. It's like color wheel they call it, or hexagonal shape, as you see. You can imagine you stand at one place and just move on the surface, you find the color is changing drastically here on this surface. And inside we have the white color. So it's a kind of cone wherein this zero is black. Zero black means here the V or the intensity is black. That means it's like reducing the intensity of the bulb. It's like you switching off the light. That is the set, the value, the intensity, that any monochrome camera will accept the image in that manner. So V or intensity, HSI model has I. So it's easy to manage now. That means HSI model is straightway towards illumination. If you are reducing the light, straightway I will keep going up. Everything is same. You are just playing with same intensity reduction. So light power is going down. Everything is same. Source is same. Product is lying at the same position. It's like we are seeing each other and the light is going down. It is just like the same color appearance will be there, but same color means only one coordinate will change. Only I will change, go to down. But if you see on the RGB, everything will change. But intensity variations are common. So that it's possible that the bulb or any source may go down with lifetime and aging. So that's the reason I model, HSI model will give us a better kind of processing, easier. So you can see the illumination variations are better dealt by considering I. So if you are not interested in color, you just take I. That means which is a mixture of RGB. There is a way to compute I from RGB that you will see now. And the hue is an angle. See the angle here, H here. So as you move across this V, or a polygon as you can see, as per the center to this angle gives you. That means if you are red, you have 0 degree. You go to yellow side, you have some 45 degree. You go to green, you get 90 to 180 degree, 20 degree. And then this cyan and magenta, and in between you have blue. So all 0 to 360 degree or minus 30 degree you can see. So now hue is an angle. It's like a, I told you, R theta coordinate system. It's like a cylindrical coordinate system or conical system here, wherein this gives you intensity and the angle gives you the hue and the radius. Now look at the radius. Radius means as the saturation increases, see the saturation S going towards away from the circle. That is radial part. So that saturation is the radius of that circle. So why we are discussing all that? I gave you a hint because that's the way the color would change, in a crop. It would be much, much more realistic to work with HSI, not in all cases, but in most cases. Or definitely RGB doesn't find a suitability in issue. It is good for display, it's good for detect, but it's not at all good for process. That is the end. So this system, therefore, the moment you acquire imaging, you have to convert it to some other model. And the model most commonly used is HSI or HSV. MATLAB calls it V for value. And now you can see how the conversion is done. Just the next. These are details, as I said, when humans see the color, we tend to describe it as HSI, as to what hue is there and what is it. It's like, okay, what's the color? Okay, red is the color. You just tell the person, color in terms of hue, and then whether it's bright or dark, we say that is the saturation. That is the intensity part. So like that, brightness, these are subjective things used for description of color. Why it is also required is because many times the agro experts will tell you. That's what happened with us. They said we want to form chips. They should be yellow with this kind. You start describing colors on language by way of human language. So that is also the reason that humans matching is easier when you use this model. No one can tell you RGB. No, I cannot tell you. You wear a shirt with R value this, G value this. You cannot imagine that. So we are not trained to work like that. It's like log system. You know, dBs for sound we use. We can't have volumes in linear scale. We have log scale because our ears perform in log scale. Same way, you know, it has, the colors have to be more like humans see the color. So this is, of course, you can have, of course, more details if you read it personally. At the moment, to a larger audience, the idea is to expose that the existing electronic devices that produce or display the color are not good for processing. So next, you can see the model calculation, how it is done. Now see, h is theta or 360 degree minus theta. That is, u I was telling you is the angle. So it's related with. So basically, it is blue in comparison to green. So it basically is a fight. It's a balance. First balance is okay. Plus 180 degree or minus 180 degree, depending upon if it is b greater than g. If it's blue is higher than red green, then means it is towards negative side of the whole 360 degree domain. If b is less than or at the x equal, then it is 0 to 180 degree. That is of course the h value. With of course theta calculation as this. Because it's a cos angle, you have to resolve whether it is minus or plus. To resolve it properly, so you can have this formula how basically r and g, r and g and r and b. Then r is used further. G and B are compared for the basic positive and negative side because cos doesn't mean that. So anyway, I mean this is an empirical formula that people have come up which matches the human kind of view, and the conversion goes as theta with cos inverse. That's it. Next. Similarly, the saturation as you saw is the radial part of it, which is 1 minus. Now see, what minus means? Minimum of means all the periphery that RGB are carrying.